everyone, and welcome to Aqua Splendor. My name is Nicolas Marion, and this is the review for the Aquatic Life T5 Hybrid Fixture. I got this light since the last 4 months. I didn't have any issue with it. I'm very pleased. They added some more customization for this light. By default, you have the 18 inch, but now they are selling a shorter bracket from here. And you can reduce the width by 16 inch. And you also have, if you have a bigger aquarium, you also have a larger bracket, 24 inches. So very customizable. This hole was made for the Kessil A360WE Tuna Blue. And you have now also a new bracket that is the hole is really small, that will fit the Kessil 160 right into that. So they have that, very pleased with that. One of the reasons why you want to have this light, because you want the LED, yeah, but you also want the T5, because you probably want the spectrum of the T5, and it gives a special look to the aquarium. For me, one of the reasons is because I just want to spread a little bit more light, because the Kessil is more like a spot. So if you have like shadow, it doesn't cover some area, so the T5 will just light the whole aquarium. One of the reasons that people really enjoy this light is because that space, you can put pretty much all light. Right now on the website, what they say about the compatibility is you can put the Kessil A360, you can put the A160, also the AP700, have also the Aquatic Radian XR15W and the XR30W. And you also have for the aqua illumination the Hydra 26 and the Hydra 52, and also for the Prime HD. But it's only just a space, so you have a bracket. I don't have the bracket right now, but you have the bracket that you can put pretty much any light, so it's very, very useful. So you have this space. Also, if you have the 16 model and you wonder how to put the bracket, all you have to do is just invert. It will take less space. Also, what I enjoy is that light is really slick. I don't have any problem with the design. I think it's very well made. Yeah, it's really simple. All you have is pretty much, all they do is they put like some bracket and you have like the ballast. Actually, I opened this unit to show you inside what was the ballast. So you can see on the video, it's the SL218-40 UNI. I don't have a lot of review, like I don't know what people say, but personally I have zero problem. It doesn't generate a lot of heat, so I'm very pleased, and it doesn't make a buzz sound. So the ballast work perfectly, I have no complaint at all. This is the kind of stuff that you want to have in your equipment, that it work and does the job. The light is made of aluminium, and I know 100% sure because I made some hole into the light. And I saw it was aluminum. They put some cover, the black powder coating on top of it to protect the light. And yeah, I like the powder. It's really a good quality. If you wonder for the cord, the electric cable, the length is about 8 inch or 2.4 meters. I think it's a really good choice of length. The other thing I really enjoy with this light is because I'm sleeping just next to my aquarium, silence is very a big thing for me, and this light doesn't make any noise at all, so I was really pleased. In my aquarium, I have an all-in-one aquarium, so I have I need to offset the light, so I cannot put my light on the center, so I have to offset. So you have this option, you can slide this bracket. All you have to do is just put some screws. And yeah, overall the light, you can customize a lot of stuff. Like you can choose of course the T5, but you can choose pretty much all kind of light in the middle. The only concern that I had was by default the light have an electric output just over there and here. Doesn't make any sense whatever your configuration of aquarium. It was only my concern, and I did some modification. So I did some hole on the bracket, and you cannot see, but there's another bracket, small bracket here. So I made two holes for those brackets, and I just inverted the light. So right now I have, as you can see, I have the two output, electric output over here. Now I don't have any issue at all with the light, so I was really pleased. The socket here is really soft. It's really easy to put the T5 no issue. The socket is soft and it's, I think it's waterproof. I'm not 100% sure, but I think it's waterproof. It's also easy to take the light out. So yeah. Also they have the reflector, so to spread a little bit more the light from the T5. What I wish they made for this light is to have like a wireless timer, because like you're in 2018, most of the light now have a wireless timer, or you can have like a device that you can put your setting. So they doesn't have anything like this in the light, maybe in the version 2 of the light, we'll see. I wish the T5 was with the ballast, was a dimmable one. Right now you cannot dim the light, it's pretty much on or off. And there's a, when you put on the light, there's a 1 second delay, I think, with the ballast. So I'm gonna show you the modification I made for this light. So I'm gonna speed up the video so it's not boring, and you will see what's inside of the ballast. So there we go. I hope you enjoyed this little time lapse for the modification about the hybrid fixture. So I put my fixture over my aquarium. And you can notice I put my hybrid fixture from like 8 inch from the surface. There's two reasons I did that. One is because when I have to put my hand in my aquarium, I just need some space, so it gives me plenty of area. And the second thing, the second reason is because the T5 are generating some heat. You will see with my thermometer how much heat it generate. But so like from this distance, I can feel the heat. So just to be safe, I just put some extra inch so it doesn't affect too much the water. So I'm going to turn on the T5. My T5 are currently plugged onto a smart plug, so I have an application on my phone and I just can put the T5 on right away. So there we go. So I hope you saw the shift of the color. Actually, I can do a little comparison like this. So we can see it's more purple because I have the Actinic and the Purple Plus from ATI. And this was my personal paste. So there we go. I hope you can see with the camera how brighter it is. I will show more the comparison between on and off later on the video. But meanwhile,
Hello, cutie pie.
Sorry about that. He's 18 years old, so he need I need to check him time to time. So I'm gonna use the power meter, which is red over here. I'm gonna show the difference between the T5 on and off with the power meter, how much it affects the light in terms of power into the aquarium. So let's do it. It's time to use my infrared thermometer. So as you can see on the side, it's 36 Celsius, which I think it's 97 Fahrenheit. So you can put your hand without any problem. All right, and now the T5. So we get around 77, 78, which is I think pretty normal for a T5. And on the bottom, we got in the range of the 60 to 70 Celsius. Okay, so now let's test with the wet paper. I just want to show you guys the temperature under the T5, because I said earlier that the T5 are warming the water. So to be just, you need to take that in consideration. So you can see at first the wet paper was had the lower value, and now I'm putting my gun a little bit higher. And you can see how much the temperature is raising. So it's something to take in consideration. So like I said earlier, I think I put my fixture about 8 inches from the water. All right, so now the decibel meter is showing 42 decibel. But this light doesn't emit any sound. This is just my ambient sound in my room. But this light is completely silenced, no buzz, nothing. Really, really good light for the silence. So now with my energy meter. So for almost 9 hours of usage, it used 0.8 kilowatt, voltage at 920, ampere 0.82, voltage lowest is at 96, and the highest output was 109. And now the current usage is 98 watt. So if you want to know how much it consumes during the day for 8 hours, you need to multiply 98 watt, multiply by 8 hours, divide by 1,784 kilowatt for the day. Now if you wonder the price, you multiply this by your local energy cost. So let's make an average of like in North America, it's 0.15 cents. So 0.15 multiplied by 0.784 equal 1176. That means it costs 11 cents per day. So now you multiply this by 30 day, equal 3.52 cents for the month. And now for the years, it's multiplied by 12. So it's an average of like $43 per year. So I hope this helped you to give you an idea how much it costs. It's not exactly that, but it's an average. So now let's see the difference between the T5 on and the T5 off. I hope you enjoyed this video. It took me a little while to do it because it was actually my very first product review. So I hope for the first one it's good enough. So if you have any suggestions, please let me know. If I did something wrong, let me know in the comments below. I will read them and maybe you can help me to improve my future video. If you think this video was really useful for you, please hit that like button. Like. And if you want to actually to see more of my video, hit that subscribe button. And so thank you very much if you watch the whole video from the beginning to the end without skipping. You're freaking hardcore, because I know my video was a little bit long. And so thank you very much, and I hope to see you later on other videos. Thank you, bye bye.